It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net. Today I am protecting my vegetables from the deer. Now, you may not have deer where you live, but we do, and they like to eat most anything. So until the tomatoes get big enough to fend off the deer for themselves, or there are too many and I don't care if they nibble on some, I have to protect them. So I have my tomato cages, which I recommend you grow your tomatoes with cages, keeping them off the ground. And on the cage, I am putting what's called deer netting. It's just a plastic cloth. It's not anything that's really strong or offensive. It kind of disappears, but it scares the deer. They bump into it and they don't like it. We found that they have it at Farm and Fleet, if you have one of those. They also have it at Menards, which is a Wisconsin family home and garden store. But it comes in rolls. This one costs about $10. You get 100 feet, and it's, how tall is this one?
Right? 7 feet.
7 feet tall. Folded. I'm just using it doubled. It comes folded in half, so I'm just using it that way with doubled. And I cut them 5 feet in length for this size tomato cage. And then I'm using these little plant twisty thingies that you can buy. I cut them and then I attach them to this bottom ring. The soil will go up to this point, so I don't need to do below that. And this also keeps the rabbits from nibbling on them and any other little creature that might be hungry for my plants. And I tack it on each pole, and then I also tack it in the middle, or tie it in the middle. And I just twist it around a couple of times. It's not too bad to work with. If it's windy, it's a little challenging, but I just tie it down, and that way there's no way they can get in. Now, as the tomato gets stronger and taller, and I need to get to it to pinch off the parts that I don't want, the extra little branches on the tomato, then I'll roll it down from the top. And I can always roll it back up again, but it's easy enough to do. Now, last year when I planted these beds, I only had 6 tomatoes in each bed. But I wanted to be more efficient this year, and I'm doing 8 in each bed this year. So I needed more cages, but I planted my tomatoes, and I didn't want the deer to sneak up on them while I didn't have enough cages. So we made one out of this, what's this called, Rick? Wire.
I think it's a half inch
metal wire. So now I'm going to take that temporary one off and put my deluxe cage over this. Now, as long as I keep these tomato bushes trimmed and not let them get out of control, there should be plenty enough room in this bed for 8 plants. Now, I usually recommend that you rotate your crop so that bugs that like tomatoes, when they come to find your garden next year, they won't be able to find it because you have something else. But I've been using my Jerry Baker resistant tonic powder that I put in the ground that I have on my website, the recipe for, and also we were very diligent about cleaning up last year, getting all the old tomatoes out, taking all the old vines out, and letting it sit the entire winter with nothing on here. So, and I've also used alpaca compost in my Jerry Baker mixture. So that should be a good nutrition for them, in addition to the dirt that we've added and the soil and the peat moss that we put in. So, and now in between each one of these cages I will be putting grass clippings, And you will also see that I have my sweet alyssum to attract the bees and my marigolds to repel the bad insects. We'll see. It's kind of pretty. Well, I've got all 40 done now, and they should be protected from deer and rabbits and whatever. Hopefully it will not freeze tonight. They're kind of iffy, but we're going to take the chance. And now it's off to the other garden where I have a few more.